I had it with this damn job. It's been 5 fucking years since I started keeping tabs on that Ronald. It's driving me crazy. How can you hope to get useful data from a brain-dead invalid stuck in an unrelenting coma? I'm beginning to think that maybe I should be the one to nudge him into terminal dreamland. Well, if that's the only way to convince upper management to assign me a new task, then so be it. At this point, I'd be better off a vegetable myself without the slightest sensations of being stuck in this goddamn job.
Doc, I'm here. It looks like an archive of some sort.
Precisely, Mr. Walker. Keep the chatter to a minimum, though. This time you won't have to shred corpses. Just park your tush in that chair by the PC and initiate the archive self-destruction sequence. The process should be rather simplistic. That is all.
Hey, Doc. I'm out here. Now let me in.
Oh, my. Mr. Walker, welcome back. You have indeed proven yourself reliable. I must admit, I couldn't have done it better myself.
Listen, man. I almost died covering up the shit you people have got hidden in here. The shit you're a part of, Doc. I thought your job was to save lives, not destroy them.
Do not presume to lecture me, Mr. Walker. I will not be scolded by the likes of you at a time like this. It boils down to business, money, and power. All of which the company has more of than you can begin to fathom. But I'm still useful to them. They'll come for me eventually. They'll come for me because I too am reliable. And that is exactly why you and I have one last task to complete.
Ah, fuck you, man! Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice. Well, I can't get fooled again. I'm done!
Just shut it and listen. An acquaintance of mine, Dr. Kimball, went missing and out of radio contact while carrying out an important job. He did, however, re-establish the signal just a few minutes ago. From what little I gathered, we've only got a few minutes to save his life. And who better than reliable you to rush to his aid, hmm? Complete this one final task for me, and I will gladly throw open this door and invite you to inside. Let me reassure you, Mr. Walker, that I am a man of my word.
Oh, fucking hell. All right! But that's it! If you don't open the door next time, I'm gonna find a way in there, and you ain't gonna like it.
That won't be necessary, Mr. Walker. Dr. Kimball seems to have locked himself in the east wing of the facility. But I'm not sure how long he'll be safe there. So please, rescue him as quickly as possible. Good luck.
Huh?
This is the place where I was born. Where it all started. Doc, it's me. Sorry, but your colleague didn't make it. I found him, but was too late to-
Mr. Walker, don't dwell on useless chatter. Just check the status of the computer equipment in the room. Did Dr. Kimball complete his work? The screen for the terminal display-
What?! Listen, Doc! I am done playing your fucking dirty little games. All I've been doing this whole time is implicating myself in whatever the hell crimes you've committed here by erasing evidence. I do not take kindly to being blackmailed by weirdo fucks in puffy white coats, and I ain't your damn puppet! My role as your accomplice in this fucked up horror tale ends now. I'm heading your way, Doc. And when I get there, you'll do well to give me exactly what I risked my ass for in this godforsaken labyrinth. Doc? Dr. Atherton, what's wrong? Answer me! Fuck, fuck, fuck! What is this?
Sam. Is that you, Sam? It's me, Sam. Please, come and help me. Hurry. Don't fail me again. Don't fail. Don't leave me behind. Please, don't.
No, this can't be happening. Not again.
14th August, 98. As all of my written requests have gone unanswered, I'm making an official complaint in the form of this police memorandum to the Hexa Court Supervisor in charge of the A-I-A Quadrant. We are in desperate need of more staff. An appalling number of OBE are being diverted here, and we're expected to do autopsy and dispose of each one. Not to mention file the atrociously time-consuming paperwork. Since the guys at the dam are always in a rush, why don't they just handle the overflow themselves? After all, they're better equipped with a more spacious facility than we are. I sincerely hope to hear from you this time. Thanking you, Dr. Peter Silberman.